Good morning, students. Okay, so in our today's class, let's begin with exercise 4M. We are going to continue with exercise 4N and 4O also. Okay, so exercise 4M. The question is work out by splitting numbers. So these all are multiplication sums, and you have to split the numbers which are there in it. You can split one number or you can split both the numbers. So you have to split the numbers into its factors. And then you need to solve. Okay, so we will see how to do this. So the first one is 5 multiplied by 62. Now here you can see that 62 is a greater number. So you can split this number into its factors. So what are the factors of 62? If we take the factor of 62 as 2, then 2 into what is 62? Let's check. 2 into what is equal to 62? How do we find factors? Divide it. Start dividing it by 2. 2, 3s are 6, 2 1s are 2. So we get 2 multiplied by 31 is equal to 62. So I split this 62 into 2 and 35 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 31. Okay. Now if you see 5 multiplied by 2, what is 5 into 2? It is equal to 10. So I write 10 and this 31 I write as it is. So now you see that here you have got 10 multiplied by 31. So multiplying 31 to 10 is very easy. You have to just add 1 0 in front of 31. So so this becomes 3 1 0, right? 31 into 10 is equal to 310. So this, you see that by splitting the numbers, our calculations have become very easy. Okay? Now the second sum. The second sum is 14 multiplied by 15. Now in this case, I will split both the numbers. I will split 14 also. We know that 2 into 7 is 14. So I write 2 into 7. Then multiplied by 15. For 15, I write 5 multiplied by 3. Okay? Now, I will take this 2 and 5 together and this 7 and 3 together. Okay? So, I write 2 multiplied by 5. Then I write 7 multiplied by 3. Okay? I can rearrange the numbers in this given part. So, I can take 5 first and then I can write 7. Okay, so I've got 2 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 3. So 2 into 5, what is 2 into 5? Why have I taken this together? Because I know 2 into 5 is 10. And if I get 10 multiplied by something, that multiplication will become very easy. That is why I want 10 here. That is why I have taken 2 and 5 together. So what is 2 into 5? 10. And then multiplied by 7 into 3 is 7, 14, 7, 3s are 21. So what is now 10 into 21 is equal to 210. So we see that the calculations have become easy by splitting the numbers into their factors. Okay. Now the third sum. The third sum is 15 multiplied by 54. Here also I will split both of the numbers. So first I split 15. 5 into 3 is 15. Then I write for 54 I write 6 9s are 54. Right. So I write 6 multiplied by 9. Now I write 5 and 6 together because I will get 5 into 6 is equal to 30. So I will get a number of multiple of 10. 30 is a multiple of 10, right? So I will write 5 and 6 together. So 5 multiplied by 6 I write and then I write 3 multiplied by 9. So what is 5 into 6? 5 into 6 is equal to 30 and 3 multiplied by 9. 9 to 18, 9 3s are 27. So I get 30 multiplied by 27. Now this 30 I can write it as 10 into 3 into 27. Right? So I have got 30. I have written 30 as 10 multiplied by 3. Now I will multiply this 30, 3 and 27 and then I will multiply the answer by 10. So what is 3 into 27? Let's find what is 27 multiplied by 3. 7 2s are 14, 7 3s are 21, 3 2s are 6, 7 8. Okay, so the answer is 81. So that is 10 multiplied by 81. So what is 81 multiplied by 10? 810. Okay, so you have to see that whether you get a multiple of 10. And once you get the multiple of 10, it becomes easy for you to multiply the given number or any number by 10 and get the answer. Okay, now the fourth sum. The fourth sum is 88 multiplied by 65. If you have any number like 88, 22, 33, you know that it is a multiple of 11 only. Right? So, 88 is a multiple of 8 into 11 is equal to 88. Now I have to find the multiple of 65. What is the multiple of 65? So how do I find the multiple of 65? Suppose I start dividing it by 5. Because in its last place, there is 5. We have seen the test of divisibility. At the last place, if it is 5 or 0, the number is multiple, can be divided by 5 only. So we start dividing by 5. 5 ones are 5, 5 threes are 15. So we get 5 and 13. And 13 is a prime number. It does not go in any other table. So the factors of 65 are 5 and 13. So I write 5 multiplied by 13. Now here you can see that if I take 8 and 5 together, 8 fives are 40. So I get 40, which is a multiple of 10 again. Right? So I will write this 8 and 5 together. Then I write 11 multiplied by 30. So what is 8 into 5? It is equal to 40. Then I multiply this 11 and 13 together. So what is 11 into 13? Let's find out what is 13 multiplied by 11. 1 3 is a 3. 1 3 1. So it is 143. 143. Now I can split this 40 as 10 into 4. Right? It is a multiple of 10. So I write 10 into 4 into 143. So now what is 143 multiplied by 4? So I have to write, I have to check what is 143 multiplied by 4. 4 3s are 12, 4 4s are 16 plus 1 17, 4 1s are 4 plus 1 5. So we get 10 multiplied by 572, which is equal to 5720. So this is our final answer, 5720. Okay? Okay, so the next one is 75 multiplied by 124. So now I will again split 75 also and 124 also. For splitting 75, I will divide it by 5. 5 ones are 5, 5 fives are 25, and 5 threes are 15. So I get 5, 5 and 3. So 5 into 5 into 3 are the factors. So what I will write, 5 into 3 is 15. So I write 75 as 5 into 15. Okay. So the 75 I have splitted as 5 multiplied by 50. Then I have to split 124. So 124, I start splitting by 2. 2 6 are 12, 2 2 are 4, 2 3 are 6, 2 1 are 2. So I have got 2 into 2, which is equal to 4. So 4 into 31 gives me 124. 31 is a prime number. We cannot further multiply it, divide it. So we get 4 into 31 is equal to 124. So now we have got 5 into 15 into 4 into 31. Now I will write this 5 and 4 together because I get 5 into 4 equals to 20, which is a multiple of 10. Then I will write this 15 and 31 together and multiply them. So 5 into 4 multiplied by 15 into 31. So 5 into 4 and 15 into 31. 5 into 4 is equal to 20, and I have to find the answer of 15 into 31. So what is 31 multiplied by 15? 5 3s are 15. 1 3 5 6 4. So the answer is 465. The multiplication of 15 and 31 is equal to 465. Now this 20 again I can write it as 10 multiplied by 2. And then 465. So now I have to find this multiplication. What is 2 multiplied by 465? So I write 465 multiplied by 2. 2 5s are 10. 2 6s are 12, 13. 2 4s are 8, 9. So the answer is 930. And 10 multiplied by 930 is equal to 9300. Okay, so this is our final answer. Okay, now exercise 4N. These are division sums. So 165 divided by 15. So I write 165 divided by 15. So we need to know the table of 15. But in case if you don't know. So first what we do, we take 2 numbers. Because this is a 2-digit number, we will take first 2 numbers. Okay? Because if we take one number, if a single digit number, that number is going to be smaller than 15, right? So it is obviously not going to go in the in this number table. So we take two numbers at the starting. So the first two numbers are 16. So we have to find a number multiplied by some number gives me 16 or lesser than 16. A number which is lesser than 16. So we know that 15 into 1 is equal to 15. So 15 into 1, I write 15 into 1 is equal to 15. Okay? So now I subtract this 15 from number 16. So what is 6 minus 5? 1 and 1 minus 1? 0. So now I have got 1. Now I take this 5 down. So this becomes 1, 5, 15. Now again we know that 15 into 1 is equal to, this number is 15 now. We know that 15 into 1 is equal to 15. So we have got 15 minus 15 equal to 0. The remainder is 0. So the answer is this, 11. So 165 divided by 15 is equal to 11. Okay, 11 is the answer. This is called as the repeated division method. Repeated means first we take two digits, we divide them, then we take the next digit down and then we divide and we continue this till all the numbers are over. Okay, and still if we want to, if the remainder is not a zero, if we continue till this, till the remainder becomes zero. But if the remainder is not zero, if you want to stop, you can stop. Or if you want to further continue, you can put point and then continue further. Okay? So now the second sum. The second sum is 84 divided by 6. So we know this is very simple. We know 6 table, right? Now 6 is a single digit number. So we take only the one digit, only one digit of the starting. So 8 we take and 6 ones are 6. 6 ones are 6. Okay, and I minus it from 8. So 8 minus 6 is equal to 2. And then we take this 4 down. Now we have got the number 24. Now 6 into what is 24? 6 fours are 24, we know. So I write 4 here. This means 6 fours are 24. Okay, and now I subtract 24 from 24. We get the answer. Remainder is equal to 0. So 84 divided by 6 is equal to 40. So the answer is 40. Okay, now we solve exercise 4O. In this exercise, we have word problems based on division. Okay, so but the division is not simple. I mean, we don't get whole numbers as an answer. We might get the answer in decimal points. Okay, so the first question is, all 623 students and their 36 teachers are going on a school trip. How many buses are needed if each bus holds 23 people? That means there is a school trip going and in that school trip 623 students are there and 36 teachers are there. Okay, so total how many people would be there? 623 plus 36. And the number of buses which they are needing is that number of buses you have to find. If one bus can hold 23 number of people, okay, in one bus 23 people can sit, and that is why we have to find for all these people to fit in how many buses would be needed. So first we will find how many total number of people are there. So how many students are there? Students are 623 and teachers are 36. So total how many people are there? 623 plus 36. So 6 plus 3 is 9, 2 plus 3 is 5 and 6. So there are 659 total number of people. Okay? Total number of people is 659. And now, if one bus holds how many people? One bus holds only 23 people. So if 23 people can be fitted, for 659 total people, how many buses would be needed? So for that, we have to divide 659 by 23. Okay, divided here. So it is 659 divided by 23. Okay, so first again, I will take two numbers. So 65. So let us check what is 23 multiplied by 2. What is 23 into 2? So 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4. So 23 into 2 is 46. 46 is very smaller than 65. So let's check for 23 into 3. 3 3s are 9, 3 2s are 6. So 23 into 3 is equal to 69. But 69 is greater than 65. So we can't take 3. 23 into 3 cannot be taken. We have to take 23 into 2 only. So I write 23 into 2 is equal to how much? 46. So I write 46. Now I have to minus 46 from 65. 5 minus 6. I carry 1 from here. So this becomes 5 and this becomes 15. 15 minus 6 is equal to 9. 5 minus 4 is equal to 1. And now I carry down this 9. So the number now which I have got is 199. So now let's check what is 23 into what number gives me a number which is nearly equal to 199. So let's check 23 into 6. 6 12, 6 3s are 18, 6 2s are 12, 13. So 138. Then 23 into 9. 9 2s are 18, 9 3s are 27, 9 2s are 18, 19, 20. So 23 into 9 is very large. It is 207. It is greater than 199. So I have to check for 23 multiplied by 8. Okay. 8 2s are 16 and 3s are 24. 8 2s are 16, 17, 18. So we get 23 into 8 is equal to 184, which is lesser than 199. Okay. We are not getting a number equal to 199 because 23 into 8 is 184 and 23 into 9 is 207. So we are not getting any number multiplied by 23 is equal to 199. We are getting a number lesser than 199. So we get 23 into 8 is equal to 184. So 9 minus 4 is equal to 5. 9 minus 1 is equal to 8. 1. 9 minus 8 is equal to 1. Now you see that this division has not ended here. The number 659 has ended, but the remainder we have still have some remainder left. So what we have to do? We can continue this division further by putting a point here. So this we can solve further. But how do we solve this? We have got 15 and 15 is lesser than 23. Right? So how do we solve this? We take a point here up. And when we take a point, we can put a number of zeros in front of this number. So, but at one time we have to put only one zero. So we put 1 0 in front of 15, so it becomes 150. Okay, so now 150 can be divided by 23. Some number which is lesser than 150 can come, right? So let's check which number can come. So we have 23 into 6 is equal to 138. Now let's check 23 into 7. 7 14, 7 3s are 21, 7 2s are 14, 15 16. So 23 into 7 is 161, which is greater than 150. So we have to take 23 into 6. So 23 into 6 is equal to 138. So I write 138. And now we subtract it. So this becomes 10. 10 minus 2 is 10 minus 8 is equal to 2. 4 minus 1 is equal to 4 minus 3 is 1. So I've got 12 now. This again we can further divide. As we have put a point here, we can add 10 again. Okay, so this becomes 120. Now for 120, check 23 into 5. So what is 23 into 5? Because 23 into 6 is 138, which is greater than 120. So we can't take 6. So let's check for 5. 5 3s are 15. 5 2s are 10, 11. So 23 into 5 is 115, which is lesser than 120. So we can take 23 multiplied by 5 is equal to 115. So I have got 10 minus 5 is equal to 5. So the remainder I've got is 5 now. Now you can go on further dividing this. Okay, you can put a 0 again and then you can further see which number will be divided and all. But here we want only one number after the decimal point, because what they have asked us the number of buses. So the answer which we have got is equal to 28.65. Can 28.65 buses be there? Can a number be, number of buses be in point? No, number of buses has to be a whole number, right? it has to be either 28 or it has to be 29. Okay, so we cannot have a number of buses in decimals. So we have to convert this number into a whole number. So to convert this 28.65, or we have to convert it to a whole number, so we can take only 0.6, because we, after the point whatever is there, we have to eliminate that, right? So we can take only one number after the decimal point. So rounding of this number, we have done rounding of numbers. So 28.6, rounding it off to the nearest number becomes what? It becomes equal to 29. Why 29? Because 6 is a number greater than 5. So if it is greater than 5, we add 1 to this number. So 8 plus 1 becomes 9. So the whole number is 29. So we need 29 buses for 659 people. Okay? This can also be solved logically. See, when we come here, till 15, we had 28 buses, right? So 28 buses are needed, but 15 people are still left, right? You can see here that before adding the 0, when we put a point, we added the 0. So before adding the 0, we were till up till here. We had got the remainder as equal to 15, right? So we see that 28 was the whole number which we got, and then after that we put a point. So if we don't want a point, we see what was the remainder. The remainder was 15. It means that after filling people in 28 buses, there were 15 people still left. So for that 15 people, we have to arrange a new bus, another bus, right? So for that 15 people, they had to arrange one more bus, okay? So, and they cannot, for 15 people, there are less number of people, so they cannot take half the bus, right? So they have to take the full bus only. So total, for the next 15 people also, they have to arrange one more bus. So 28 plus 1 becomes 29. So for 659 total people, they will need 29 buses for the trip. Okay? Okay. Now the second sum. A car can travel 12 kilometers in 1 liter of petrol. How many liters of petrol would you need for a journey of 208 kilometers? So there is a car which can travel 12 kilometers in 1 liter of petrol. So if we want to travel a journey of 208 kilometers, then how many liters of petrol will we need to put in the car? Okay, so that we have to find. So first I write, in 1 liter of petrol, how much does it travel? In 1 liter it travels 12 kilometers. Okay, so to travel for 208 kilometers, here see, below kilometers I have written kilometers. So to travel for 208 kilometers, how many liters of petrol would it need? Okay, in 1 liter it travels 12 kilometers. In how many liters will it travel? 208 kilometers. So I have written in like one below the other, liters below liters and kilometer below kilometer. So now I have to cross multiply. So on cross multiplying, you can see that 1 will get multiplied to 208 and this question mark will get multiplied to 12. Now we want to find this question mark. How many liters would we need? That we have to find. So we have to take this 12 on the other side. Now we know that multiplication and division are inverse operations. So if we take 12 on the other side, it will get divided. Why? Because here it is multiplied. So we get 1 into 208 is equal to 208 divided by 12 is equal to question mark. So if we find the answer of this division, we will get the question mark answer. So we have to divide 208 by 12. So let's divide 208 by 12. Okay? So first we take first two numbers, that is 20. So 12 into 1 is 20, 12 2s are 24. So we have to take 1 only. So 12 1s are 12. Then 20 minus 12 is equal to 8. So I've got 8 and 8 again. This 8 I have taken down. So 88. Now we have to check by which number multiplied by 12 gives me a number which is nearly equal to 88. I mean lesser than 88. So let's check for 12 into 4, 4 2s are 8, 4 1s are 4. So 12 into 4 is 48 and 88 is very larger than 48. So we have to check the further numbers also. So let's check for 12 into 6. So what is 6 2s are 12, 6, 7. So we get 72. 12, 6 are 72. Now let's check for 7 also. 12 into 7. What is 12 into 7? 7 2s are 14. 7 1s are 7. 8. 84. So we get 12 into 7 is equal to 84, which is nearly equal, lesser than 88. Right? So we have to take 12 into 7 is equal to 84. Now 8 minus 4 is equal to 4. Now here we have got 4 as a remainder. So we cannot further solve it. If we want to solve it, we have to put a decimal point and take a 0 here. Right? So we get 40 now. So 40 for 40, let's check 12 into 4 is 48. So 12 into 3 will be what? 3 2s are 6, 3 1s are 3. So 36. So we will have to take 3. 12 3s are 36. 40 minus 36 is equal to 4. So we get again, we get 40. So again 4, 12 3s are 36 will come. So this 4, 4, 4 we are going to be, we are going to get it again and again. This 4 will be continued. Okay, this is continuing. This 3, 3, 3 will go on continuing up till infinity. Okay, so we have to stop somewhere, right? So we can stop after 2 decimal numbers only. So we write, the answer is 17.33, or we can even round it off to the nearest number. So if I have to round it off to a whole number, I will check after 17, after the decimal point, which number is coming? 3. 3 is lesser than 5. So rounding off to the nearest number, whole number, we get 17. Or if you want to even keep it as 17.3, that will be okay. Why? Because this is petrol. How much liters of petrol will be needed? Right? So liters can be in points. We can call it a 17.3 liters, 17.4 liters. We can call it, right? So that is why we can even either convert it to a whole number or keep it in decimal points also. Now the third question. 72 sweets are to be shared between 30 children. How many whole sweets will each child receive? That means they have asked how many whole sweets. Whole means full. A sweet has to be received full. Okay, that should be full. It should not be broken. It should not be half or some part of the sweet. Okay, so how many whole sweets will each child receive? So how many sweets are there? 72 sweets are there, and they are to be shared between 13 children. So we have to divide 72 by 30. Okay, so sweets are 72, and children are, number of children is 30. So we have to divide 72 by 30. Okay, so let's start dividing. 13 into, let's see, for 13 into 4, 4 3s are 12, 4 1s are 4, 5. So it is 52. Then 13 into 6, 6 12, 6 3s are 18, 6 7. So we get 78. 13 into 6 is equal to 78, but 78 is greater than 72. So we have to take 13 into 5. So 5 3s are 15, 5 1s are 5, 6. So we get 13 into 5 is 65. So 13 5s are 65. Now 72 minus 65, 12 minus 5 is equal to 7. Okay. Now, if I put a point here, now this has, this, the number which I've got is 7. But 7 is lesser than 13. So if I have to continue this division, I will have to put a point here, a decimal point, and I will have to put a 0 here and then continue. But putting a point here means what? I am, this is the whole number of sweets. Every child will get 5 sweets. But if I put a point further of it, then it means that I am, the remaining sweets which are there, I am breaking them and then distributing among the children. Okay? So that is why if I put a point here, that number will not be a whole number. But we want a whole number, because how many whole number of sweets will each child get, that we want to find. So we cannot find this answer into points. Into points, finding the answer in points means what? We are breaking the remaining sweets which are there. I am giving the children the sweets, and if suppose I give each child 5 sweets and still I have some sweets remaining. I have 7 sweets remaining. But how many children are there? There are 13 children. So I cannot divide this 7 for 13 children, right? So I have to break 7 sweets into some amount and give each child. If I have to give the sweets for all 13 children, the remaining 7 sweets for all 13 children, I will have to break them, right? But they have asked us to find only the whole number of sweets. How many whole sweets does each child get? That is why we have to stop here. Okay, with this division we stop. The whole number is 5. So each child will get how many whole sweets? How many? 5 whole sweets. So we write each child will get 5 whole sweets. Okay, so this is our answer. So according to the question also, we have to check whether we have to find the answer in decimal points or if we have to stop or in a whole number. Okay, so according to the first question also, where they had told us to find the number of buses, in that case we had some people still left, that is why we had to add one more bus. Okay, and that we did by rounding of the number. By logic also we can find by 28 buses are full and then 15 people are still more remaining, that is why we need one more bus. So we add one more, that is 28 plus 1, which becomes 29. Now for this, they had asked us how many whole number of sweets does each child get. So for a whole number, we don't have to go to decimal points. We just have to stop wherever, whatever answer we have got. Okay? We cannot further divide by putting a decimal point because they have asked us the answer in a whole number. Okay? So this was it about exercise 4O. And with this exercise, we finish the chapter. From our next class, we will begin with a new chapter. Okay? So, I hope everyone has understood this. And we stop. We will meet in the next class. Goodbye, students.